Erev Tov, Chavrim, I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. And as we brought out earlier this morning, thanks to Dr. Rosa, she shared this first breaking news with us about this missile test that was actually coming out of Pyongyang. And of course, very interesting about this missile test because the missile, of course, one was fired from a residential area. It seems like Kim Jong-un is definitely trying to let the world know that he can fire a missile from pretty much anywhere. So if you decide to attack the country, don't expect that you're going to get the target in the right area because, well, his missile could come from just about anywhere. Kind of seems that's exactly what he's trying to do there. And of course, the missile actually went the highest ever. It has actually gone. Reuters speaking about this right here, showing here on Yonhap News there. They're talking about how that this missile traveled some 4,500 kilometers. And of course, as far as what we can see in the article right here, it says the South Korean military said the missile fired on a steep trajectory reached an altitude of 4,500 kilometers. That's 2,800 miles and flew 960 kilometers or a distance of 600 miles before landing in a Japan's exclusive economic zone. That lets us know that Kim Jong-un definitely, as the U.S. is suspecting, that this is not just a ballistic missile, but an ICBM, an intercontinental ballistic missile. You just don't fire that high up into the air and not expect this missile, if they decide to launch it towards the United States, to reach its intended destination. So I would have to say, when we look at the biblical passage there, in Daniel 11:44, tidings out of the north and out of the east, that greatly troubles that king of the north there. I'm not talking about so much about President Donald Trump there, but as stated over and over and over, Mekasiphon is a hidden king. It is a king that, well, we don't quite really know who he is, which kind of makes me wonder a little bit about Obama to meet with world leaders. Now, this is something that seems kind of interesting. The Hill saying that former President Barack Obama will meet with Chinese President Xi Jinping and Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi in an upcoming trip abroad. Obama will visit China and India before making a stop in Paris, according to the spokesperson for the former president. Obama will speak at various summits in three countries he visits. Now, isn't it kind of ironic that some of these countries have a lot to do with, of course, in the case of China, North Korea, in the case of the French president, has a lot to do with Syria and even possibly Sudan. Just cannot help but wonder, how is the former president having so much leverage on the world stage, almost like he's showing up President Trump as he goes there? In fact, you might even wonder if it's not the choice of the shadow government to have their own spokesman doing their bidding for them as he goes around the world. Kind of interesting, in my opinion. Also, what's interesting as well is, according to NorthKoreanNews.org, South Korean president warns against misjudgment in the wake of a third DPRK ICBM launch there. Any consideration of a preemptive strike on North Korea must be prevented, says President Moon. I kind of always find this interesting as well, because what are we doing? Having massive military drills with South Korea. And of course, we're always talking about, we got to protect South Korea. I can understand the United States wanting to protect the United States, but let's just be honest about it. We're trying to protect our own interests. We do have military bases in the region. We have them in Japan. We have them in Guam. We have them in South Korea. You know, because when it comes to the president of South Korea, he's not so anxious about trying to take down Kim Jong-un. He believes that there could be a better solution to this crisis to begin with. And quite frankly, I think that Kim Jong-un does what he does only to try to show that he is a power to be reckoned with. I don't really think the man is really wanting a suicide mission of launching an attack on the United States because clearly he does not have the ability to win the war to begin with. It's a suicide mission of sorts, unless he intends on that type of mission. I don't really know. Very troubling indeed, if you ask me there. Also, I was looking at this on Yonhap News as well. This is where it shows in their article here. Apologize for the advertisement in the way of that, though, but actually shows where they were firing from a more of a residential, not like firing it out of somebody's backyard. It's not like a barbecue fireworks here going off, but the point being, it is not at a typical place where they normally would fire their missiles from. But clearly, I saw in one article there, they were actually saying that, Trump should just take out the launching pad. Well, that's the whole point of this. Kim Jong is showing that he can launch from anywhere he would like to. Lindsey Graham is also, he's weighing in on this. He believes that we definitely should take him out sooner than later.
But I believe every test puts them closer. And the president has said, we'll take care of it. Not the United Nations, not China. We'll take care of it. And my hope is that North Korea will realize that he is serious about this. The president is not going to allow North Korea to have a nuclear weapon in their hands that can hit America with an ICBM that can make it to the United States. And if we have to go to war to stop this, we will. And if there's a war with North Korea, it'd be because North Korea brought it on itself. And we're headed toward a war if things don't change.
Well, that could result in tens of...
I would have to say that Lindsey Graham is right on that. We are headed towards a war. And of course, there's a lot to say about North Korea being to blame. Kim Jong-un has brought it upon himself. I would agree with that in part as well. Although I do feel like that maybe there's more we could do to try to avert a war. Anything to try to save life. I'm just not for Agenda 21 and trying to lower the world's population by killing everybody as some, I think, would prefer to do. Also, another thing that's interesting as well, speaking about war, this here on Civil Mill Air, found this on Lorenzo's Twitter page, already happened. It says here, Cobra Ball Airborne Ballistic Missile Detection Platform, no position showing, but the U.S. Air Force, they have put their ballistic detecting aircraft in the air 8 hours ago and monitoring the situation around North Korea. And I still think that that's important because Lindsey Graham mentions that if they get this type of technology, the U.S. would have to go to war in order to stop the mainland United States from being threatened. But my question is although he's always firing them short of reaching the distance to the United States, it's always, 600 miles or so falling in Japan or going over the Japan and stuff, but the mere fact that his missiles are able to go nearly 3,000 miles up into space, I think he pretty well has the ability to get it to the United States as well. That may be one reason why also we talk strong words in America, not saying that we're bluffing, but we're talking strong words, but at the same time flexing our own muscle back at North Korea because of the fact the man does have nuclear weapons and the United States is not so excited about trying to take on a nation that is armed with nuclear weapons, not so much just the fact what it could do in the United States, but also what it could do abroad to our allies and as well as our own military forces, Americans that are living in Japan as well as Guam, South Korea, and other places such as that. So it is very troubling. At the same time, we know that China is fully arming up on full alert 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. That may have a lot to do, too. They knew that North Korea had been planning on doing this launch, wondering whether or not the U.S. would do a preemptive strike as a result, wondering if the U.S. is going to figure that this is provocative enough, we must move ahead, et cetera. It's hard to say. I'm sure the U.S. has enough backing by the American people if the president feels that he has to go to war with North Korea. But my big concern is would it stay contained or would it overspill? Would Russia get involved? Would China get involved? And if either one of those nations get involved, will it spill all the way over to Syria? Will the U.S. have to then try to take down Syria? In that case there, the Saudis and Israel would get involved because then the Saudis would target Iran. This would be the opportune time. Israel as well, defending its own borders and no doubt would get into issues maybe even whether it be Syria, Iran, Lebanon, etc. in that region of the world war. And of course, if that comes down to it, of course, Russia then really getting involved because not only is it on their southeastern corner of the country, but now Russia with their own military presence in Syria, if it spills over that far, then we would end up having a theater maybe even in Europe because Russia being involved, they're on both sides of the hemisphere. So it would be a major catastrophe, to say the very least there. Turning in a couple of other news stories that are going on right now, there was a gas leak in Israel and actually in a little place called Jaffa Yaffa, how you say it in the Hebrew language there. At first, they were not sure what caused the explosion. It killed three people, left several people injured there. The little bitty town of Jaffa is just right there near Tel Aviv. In fact, if you go down the Tel Aviv beach, you can see the little point that jets out into the Mediterranean Sea. Beautiful, beautiful city. Of course, it's the famed biblical place there where Peter goes, and he's residing there when he has the vision about the first Gentile that sends word for him to come and talk to him about Yeshua being the Messiah. And of course, we know the rest of the story about that. I think it's just a beautiful story, beautiful place. So it's sad to hear that tragedy has struck Jaffa and the residents there that have been killed in this blast. Very, very disturbing indeed. One last bit of news here, and I don't know the latest on this story here, but President Trump says, I don't see a deal. Trump says government shutdown likely. Cities are weak. Our sites weak on crime. Democrats are weak on, just weak on crime is what his whole issue is on this. Also, he speaks about the taxes. They're wanting to put this, the Democrats want to make sure that the wealthiest of the nation don't get their tax cuts. And I can't say as I blame them, you know, the poor guys, we would like to see somebody else help foot the bill besides all the poor people in the world. But then again, the wealthy are always trying to say that they need the tax break in order to bring about more jobs. I think they're pretty good at making jobs just by creating more business. The problem is making them keep the jobs at home. Maybe that's where the taxes ought to be placed at. If you're going to move your business abroad, then you should be heavily taxed. If you're going to keep your business in America, then there might be more consideration for tax cuts. Anybody ever thought about that idea as a possibility? Nonetheless, the president says that it could shut the government down because they're not making consensus here. He says on his Twitter page here, meeting with Chuck and Nancy today about keeping government open and working. Problem is, they want illegal immigrants flooding into our country unchecked, are weak on crime, and want to substantially raise taxes. I don't see a deal. You know, speaking about illegal immigrants coming into the country, I did notice as we're getting ready to have to head to Europe there, take care of my wife, some medical things there that we can do over there because we are insured in Europe. We notice on there, coming back into the country, there's a lot of new restrictions. President Trump has definitely made it a heck of a lot harder to get back in here. So Homeland Security, you can count on it. You're going to definitely be checked. And speaking of her, we do appreciate your help so much in making her medical expenses possible. We have really gone deep into the medical expenses now and getting close to the end of that. It is an expensive process there. She's had some very good days and some very bad days there. And she's going to an even more aggressive treatment campaign, hoping that we can avoid surgery, because if we do the surgery, there's a lot of risk with that. And of course, that will only mean even further infusions afterwards there. So we appreciate your help. If you would like to continue on that, our GoFundMe site that's on Israeli News Live Facebook page, which I'll include a link here at the end of this video, you can contribute there. And of course, the ministry itself, the news broadcast, if these news are a blessing to you, do pray for us as well as help support the broadcast. Your support is what keeps us on the air, and we hope and pray that you'll be watching also on several platforms that we're on besides here on YouTube. We have the Noon Institute on YouTube. Our biblical teachings just uploaded another message over there the other day. And also we're on Hebrew Nation Radio, a program called Flashpoint. If you go to Hebrew Nation Radio, look up Flashpoint. Just an exciting weekly review that we do there. It airs about two or three times a week. We're also... I can't even get my brain to think today there, but just, I'm sorry. DirecTV as well, channel 367. And you know, you guys, a lot of you guys are the ones that help make that broadcast possible. And the reason being is because we feel that it reaches an audience that does not come on the internet. You're looking at a much older generation, and we really dive deep. We air it here on YouTube as well, so you guys get to see it as well. But we're trying to reach the generation that is the older generation that stays on the television, that's not much into the internet, but giving those biblical insights. And you're the ones that are making that possible. And we really thank you for your love for my family, as well as your love for those that need to hear the gospel. I've got some very serious things coming down on. That's why I'm really encouraging you. Go to the Noon Institute. So, you know, get subscribed on our YouTube channel called the Noon Institute. We're bringing out some very strong messages there. God bless you. Shalom and good evening.